Hello kids, are you ready to listen to me and watch the video carefully? What are we going to learn? We are going to complete our lesson number 2 of EVS 1. And what is the name of the lesson? Can you see it on the screen? The interrelationships between living things. Yes, right. Now what are we going to learn in today's video? We are going to learn about the uses of plants. How are plants important to human beings in many different ways? And what we watched in the last video, we saw about the uses of animals, yes or no? But in today's video, we are going to learn about plants. How are they useful to human beings? Are you clear? And what do we do before we start the video? We learn the new words. So let us learn the new words. Can you see the first one? P-E-S-T-I-C-I-D-E-S, pesticides. And see the second one also. I-N-S-E-C-T-I-C-I-D-E-S, insecticides. Now pesticides and insecticides are both kind of medicine, which are sprayed on plants to protect them from insects, worms and other dangerous things which affects the plants and which destroys the plants. So when these medicines are sprayed on the plants, it protects the plant. What does it do? It protects the plants. It is kind of a medicine of the plant. Okay, now see the third one. A-R-B-O-R-E-A-L, it is arboreal. Now this, the third word you might have heard for the first time, yes or no? Now what do you mean by arboreal? It is a kind of it is a term which is used for animals. It is like arboreal animals. Those animals which live on the trees are known as arboreal animals. Is that clear? Now see the fourth one. E-G-R-E-T, egret. Now, egret is a kind of a bird. I'll show you the picture in the video. When we watch the video further, you will see the picture of the egret. Okay? It is pronounced as egret. So, are you familiar? And now, do you know to pronounce these new words and you know the meaning of each word? Yes? I hope you have made a note of these words in your notebook. Is that clear? Now, let me move on further. See the first one, uses of plants. Yes, this is what we are going to study today. We are going to learn about the uses or about the benefits of plants. What all things do we get from plants and how are they useful to us in many different ways? This is what we are going to learn in today's video. Okay, see the first one. Just as we need animals, we need plants too. Very, very right. Yes. Animals are also important to us, as well as plants are also important to us, because plants, animals, we and the natural things in the nature, we together form an environment. Yes or no? We are a part of our nature and we all are equally important. So as animals are important for us, plants are also important to us. Is that clear? Now see, what do we get from plants? We get food grains. Yes, dal, whatever you have daily in your food, this all, majority of the things are provided by the plants. Can you see the picture of the food grains there? Yes. Now move on to the next one. Vegetables, very, very important. We have vegetables every day for our lunch, for our dinner. And where do we get vegetables from? We get it from plants. Plants provide us with vegetables. Yes. See the next one. Fruits. Can you see colorful fruits there? Which are very, very tasty and which are very, very juicy. And who gives us this? Plants provide us with fruits. Yes or no? Fruits are very tasty and you should all make a, you know, you should make it compulsory to have fruits every day. Whatever it is, banana a day, an apple a day, a pomegranate, whatever it is. But you should eat fruits daily because fruits keep us healthy. Yes or no? And fruits provide us with many nutritional values which are important for our body. They are tasty also. They are sweet. Some are sour. But they are very good to eat. And it is very good for our body. Is that clear? So we should eat fruits daily. And who gives us fruits? Plants provide us with fruits. Is that clear? See the next one. Flowers. Yes. We, you know, during special occasions, it is a wedding or whatever, a birthday party or small some function, we usually give flowers. Flowers is a, you know, symbol of happiness. When you give flowers to someone, that person feels very, very happy because flowers smell sweet. They look attractive. You can give it as a present to someone. Yes or no? So plants provide us with different and beautiful kind of flowers. If you visit flower garden sometimes, you will feel very, very nice, very, very attractive, and you will be, you know, interested in knowing more about flowers and flowers. When you look at the flower garden, it will be so colorful and so attractive. Is that clear? So flowers make a person happy because they are a symbol of happiness and they can be given as a gift to someone. Okay, so who provides us with flowers? Plants provide us with flowers. Is that clear? And various things are made from flowers. Yes or no? Bouquets are made from flowers. Garland are made from flowers. Yes or no? So flower decorations are there. Torans are made of flowers. So there are different things which are made from flowers, and they are very, very pretty. They are very, very attractive. Okay, so let us move on further. Cotton wool. Now what is a cotton wool? See, there is a cotton plant. We get cotton from plant. Yes, cotton plant is there, and like flowers, cotton come on those plants, and these are those cotton wool. These are called cotton wool. As we pluck fruits from the trees, cotton is plucked from the cotton plant, and that is known as cotton wool. Is that clear? See the next one. Cotton clothes are made from cotton wool. Yes. See, this is cotton wool. What is made from cotton wool? Threads are made from cotton wool, and from threads clothes are made. Which clothes are made? It is cotton wool. So cotton clothes are made from cotton wool. Is that clear? Okay. We grow plants that are useful for us. Yes. Now what are the steps for growing a plant? What things should we consider and what things we should take care of while growing plants? Is that clear? And we grow plants that are useful for us. Each and every kind of plant is useful for us, as plants give out oxygen. They give us fresh air. So whichever plant it is important because it gives fresh air. It gives us oxygen, and oxygen is necessary for us to breathe. We inhale oxygen. Yes or no? So oxygen is our daily support. Without oxygen, we cannot survive. And if you plant more and more of trees, you get fresh air more and more, and you remain healthy and fit forever. So you should always, this also I'm not telling is that important, but I hope that you should all have a small plant in your house, like in your, you know, in, you can keep it in your balcony, you can keep it in your window. So whatever it is, but you should plant a small plant. Slowly, slowly, when you start taking care of the plant, when you water the plant every day, when it gets proper sunlight, soon it will become a very beautiful plant. Okay, and you'll get something from it. If you plant a rose plant, you'll get roses from it, which you can use for your puja. You can offer it to God, or you can make something out of it. You can make a garland, you can make a bouquet out of it. Whatever you like, you grow a small plant wherever you have space outside your house, in your window, in your balcony, wherever it is, because we should grow plants and we should save plants. Yes or no? Because plants are very important for us. They are very useful for us. Is that clear? Now see this. This is a pot. A small plant is grown in that pot. And we are going to see how a plant is grown. Okay. first, we sow seeds. Yes, very, very important. Whichever plant you want to grow, you should sow the seeds. Suppose I want to sow a coriander plant, that is kothimbir. In Hindi or Marathi, it is known as kothimbir. So I will take the seeds of the coriander and put it in the mud. Yes or no? That means I'm sowing the seeds. What I will do, second thing, I will water the plants. Yes, I will water the plant every day without fail. And you should keep the plant in such a way that it gets proper sunlight. Sunlight is also very important for the plant to grow well. See the third one, manure. Now, manure means, as we learned in the last video, the waste materials or the waste matter of the animals is known as manure. Is that clear? If you get it, you can put it in your plant because it is very useful for the plant. And the next one is pesticides or insecticides. Now we in our house, we cannot grow big trees. Yes or no? We can grow a small plant. So for that, pesticides or insecticides is not needed. But for farmers, those who grow crops, those who grow big trees, fruits, trees and whatever, they need insecticides and pesticides because they are in an open area. They are in the fields and insects, rats, anything can come and they can eat the crops, they can damage the crops. So for the farmers, pesticides or insecticides is important to be sprayed on the crops or on the plants. Is that clear? And if you keep these four things in mind while growing a plant, your plant will grow out very well. Is that clear? And it will yield good whatever fruits. If it is a fruit plant, you'll get lot of fruits from that plant. If it is a flower plant, you'll get lot of flowers from that plant. Is that clear? So have you understood what are the steps of planting a tree and what you should keep in mind while planting a tree? Is that clear? Can I move on further? Yes. Now, plants give us abundantly. We saw all the things which plants give us, and what is the summary? Means what we can conclude from it, that plants give us abundantly. Abundantly means in more quantity and lot of things and variety of things which are useful for human beings. That is why the statement is plants give us abundantly. Means more and more and more and different kinds of varieties we get from plants, which are very, very important for us. Without plants, we cannot survive. Remember this thing, okay? Other living things also get their food from nature. Other living things means animals. Yes, we saw in the last video, again I'm trying to make you remember that what we saw, each animal is dependent on something which it gets from the nature for its food. So same way, other living things also get their food from nature. See the first picture. Chameleon eats insects. Yes. Now, the chameleon is eating an insect. Because it eats insect, it is its food. It is the food of the chameleon. And that is why it eats insects. Okay. See the next one. What it is? A snake is eating mice, or you can say a mouse. So snake's food is mice and frogs. They eat this. Okay. See the third one. Yes. A national animal, that is the tiger. What it is eating? Tiger is eating a deer. Yes. It has hunted the deer and now it is ready to kill and it is ready to eat. So what we saw in these pictures, we saw that different animals eat different things. Either they are dependent on other animal, or either they eat plants, leaves, grass, whatever they get it from the nature. See the next one. Goats and sheep eat leaves. Yes. So goats, their food is grass and their food is leaf of the plants and trees. So they eat this. See the next one. Sheep is grazing. Sheep is eating grass. So these animals are herbivorous animals. Do you remember that? Herbivorous animals eat only plants, leaves, grasses. And carnivorous animals eat other animals. Is that clear? See, a cow is grazing in the field. So a cow is also a carnivorous animal. A cow is eating grass. Okay, that is its food. Now see the next one, which is very, very important for you to learn a new concept. Arboreal animals. Okay, as I told you in the new words, arboreal animals are those animals which live on the trees. Yes or no? Now see, the word arboreal comes from the Latin word arbor, which means trees. Yes, in Latin, arbor means trees. And then arboreal becomes animals living in the trees. Is that clear? Is this concept very clear? What do you mean by the word arboreal has come from a Latin word, that is arbor. Arbor is a Latin word. And what is the meaning of that word arbor? Means trees. In Latin, arbor means trees. And what we are learning? Arboreal animals. So arboreal animals are those animals which live in the trees. See, animals living on trees are called as arboreal animals. See the examples now. Monkeys, yes. You all must have seen a monkey. Okay, somewhere. So monkeys live on trees. Squirrels. Isn't it cute? Squirrels too live on trees. Yes. Now, these arboreal animals, they live on trees. That means trees are their shelter. Trees are their homes. Now, in return, they help the trees too. Yes. Did you hear me? In return, the arboreal animals help the trees too. Now there is a big question mark in front of you. How can these animals help the trees and plants? I'll tell you. When these animals are living on the trees and they move from one tree to another. Yes or no? See, can you see a bird is eating a fruit? Okay, it is sitting on a tree and it is eating a fruit. So these animals and birds, when they eat something which they get from the plants, from the trees, they drop some of it down. Yes or no? The seeds of the fruits are fallen down. And because of it, what happens? New trees come. New trees grow in that places. Means these animals and birds, when they are eating fruits of the trees the seeds are fallen down. Maybe something is fallen down. See, even we have food, something or the other, a morsel of your food or something, or piece of chapati, papad, some small pieces of papad, you can see it on the floor. Okay, so same way these animals also, while eating, some of the parts of the fruits are fallen down, and when they fall, they mix up with the soil and new trees grow in that places. So what are they doing? They are helping trees. They are helping our nature to grow more and more trees. It is not that they are doing it, you know, knowingly. It happens unknowingly with them. But actually, what are they doing? They are helping. They are helping the new trees to grow. And how are they helping? When they are eating, that is called their droppings. When they drop certain things while they are eating, like seeds or the parts of the fruits, that are called droppings. So through their droppings, new trees grow in that area. Is that clear? So am I clear now how these animals, arboreal animals, and how these birds help trees? They help trees by growing new trees through their droppings. Is that clear? See, birds build nests on the trees. So birds also live in the trees. They also build their shelter in the trees. But they in return help the trees by their droppings. When they eat something, the seeds fall down, and in that place new trees come again. You know? Is that clear now? Okay. Now, why does an egret ride on buffalo's back? Now, I'll show you what is an egret. Can you see this? You must have seen this small bird. A white small bird is sitting on the back of the buffalo. And what it is doing? It is not taking a ride and it is not, you know, what it is doing. It is sitting on the buffalo because it wants to eat the insects which are in the grasses. Now, while buffalo, see, the egret cannot see the insects which are hiding in the grasses. So, it sits on the back of the buffalo. And when the buffalo is grazing the grass, what happens? The insects gets frightened. And then it flies, then it goes here and there. And as soon as the insects flies away from the grass, the egret catches it immediately and it eats the insect. Is that clear? So that is the reason why an egret sits on buffalo's back to eat the insects which are hidden in the grasses. And who helps the egret? A buffalo helps an egret because it is grazing the grass and it is walking on the grasses and it is eating the grasses. The insects get frightened and they fly away. And when they are flying away, the egret immediately catches them and eats them. Is that clear? So maybe you must have seen this picture somewhere in the Animal Planet, Discovery Planet, or somewhere in the newspaper, magazine, or some books. And you must be just looking at it. Why is that bird sitting on that buffalo? And do you know the reason why it is now? Clear? Now let us take a short recap of what we have studied in today's video. We have studied about the uses of plants. Yes. Plants give us abundantly. They provide us with variety of things which are useful to human beings as well as for animals too. Is that clear? Then growth of plants. We saw how to grow a plant and what all things are important to grow a plant. What we do first? We sow seeds. Yes. Then we water the plant. Then we add manure to it. And then we spray insecticides and pesticides to protect the plants from germs and insects. Is that clear? Then the next one, arboreal animals. Yes. What are arboreal animals? Those animals living on trees are known as arboreal animals. And you've seen the examples. What were the examples of arboreal animals? Monkeys, squirrels, okay? So these animals which live on the trees are known as arboreal animals. And arbor is a Latin word which means trees. Okay. And see the last one. Egret rides on a buffalo. Do you know the reason now? Why does an egret rides on a buffalo? Because it wants to eat the insects which are hidden in the grasses. And who helps the egret? A buffalo helps the buffalo helps an egret. How? As the buffalo is grazing on the grasses, the insect gets frightened and it flies off. And as soon as the insects fly, an egret catches the insects, you know, immediately, and it eats the insects. This is how a buffalo helps an egret. And this is the reason why an egret rides on a buffalo. So we have studied all these things in today's video, and this is not the end of the chapter. It is little bigger chapter, so we are going to learn in parts, and I will see you in the next video. I hope you have understood this video and I hope you have noted down the important things. Is that clear? As of for now, bye and take care. See you in the next video.